for a lot of people, just trying to get an 03, 04 Terminator Cobra is quite a challenge on its own. But once you have one and you start modding them, that's when it becomes pretty expensive, especially the four valve Cobras, because they're just an expensive engine to mod to begin with. But beyond that, prices for things lately, not just car parts, and I'm not trying to get all political in my videos, but I just wanted to make a point that, man, car parts have gotten insanely expensive. And I kind of thought of this video like a year ago, and that was when I did my update on what does it cost to build my car. And when I did that, I went back in the video, and what I paid for the parts at the time that I actually bought them versus the time that I made the video, there was a steep jump in a lot of prices on stuff that I had bought. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through some of the mods that I bought for my car and compare what did I pay for it at that time that I bought it, and what do those parts cost now, and how much more would it cost to mod my Cobra the way I have it now if I were to buy those mods now versus when I bought them at the time before these prices, went through the roof on a lot of stuff. Now, I'm not going to go through every single part that I have on the car. Obviously, some parts have not gone up, but I went through ahead of time and picked out specific ones that did go up in price quite a bit from the time that I bought it. And at the end of this, I will do a grand total of how much more it would have cost to build my car now for these specific parts versus what I actually paid for it. The first part that I would like to show you guys is these 1994 to 04 Mustang front brake rotors, 13-inch drilled and slotted for Cobra, Bullitt, and Mach 1. I originally bought these in December of 2020, so at the time of recording this video, just short of 2 years. I'm recording this on the last day of November 2022. At that time, these rotors cost $124.99, so they have increased by $100 in just 2 years. The next part is a set of Maximum Motorsports full-length subframe connectors, powder-coated. These are for 79 to 04 Mustang, so not necessarily a Cobra-specific part, but it is a part that went up in price. I also bought these in December of 2020, so just short of 2 years. And these are actually going on the car this winter. I've had them that long without going on the car. But the price for them back then was $194.97. Now they are $229.97. So they have not gone up quite as much as the brake rotors did, but still a pretty good jump. Up next is the new suspension that I bought for the Cobra. I purchased this Koni setup back in 7:30 of 21, so July 30th of 2021. At the time that I bought this, it was, hold on 1 second, $766. It is now $897. Now, I haven't done any picking on lethal performance yet, but don't worry, they're coming up now. I originally bought this 26 spline input shaft back in November of 2021. At that time, it was $299.99. Now it is $359.99. Continuing on with lethal performance, these next two are probably the most egregious ones out of all the parts that I picked. Exhaust components are friggin' insane right now for what it costs to buy. Probably not just Cobras, probably anything at this point. Now, this is probably the biggest discrepancy of what I have from when I bought it to what it costs now, because a cab back system was actually bought for the Cobra before I took delivery of it. As a lot of you know, I bought the car from Florida. As soon as the car was on the trailer and shipped to come up here, I had bought the exhaust system so that I would have it, or the cab back system, so that I would have it for when the car arrived and I could immediately get it put on. So this is the very first part that I ever bought for the Cobra. I bought this system in July of 2020. The car arrived very early August. At that time, when I bought this cab back system, it was $763. It is now $1,095 for a cabback system, for a stainless steel system. Granted, Borla is excellent quality, the fitment, the sound, the material they make it out of, but my God, $1,000 for a cabback system is pretty hard pill to swallow. Because we all love lethal performance, the next thing up is the long tube headers that I bought for the Cobra. Those are actually going on this winter. They are the American Racing headers. They are 1 3/4 with 3-inch primary, 1 3/4 primary with 3-inch merge collectors with a 30-inch X pipe that's necked down to 2.5 for the cabback. I bought these long tubes in January of 2022, so it hasn't been that long since I bought them. It's basically been 1 year, give or take a month or so. At that time when I bought them, the same exact setup that you have, that I have listed up here, was $1,706. It is now $2,113. So as you can see, exhaust components have probably been one of the worst things as far as price increases go. Now, just as a bullet point that I want to make about all this before I get to the totals of everything, I know that these price increases are not being done out of malicious intent by the companies selling these. They have to get their parts from vendors. If the vendors are charging more, then it all trickles down to us. That's the unfortunate reality. If it's costing American Racing headers and Borla more money to make their products, it costs the vendors more to buy them and then sell them to us. So it's all a trickle-down effect. And I get that. So I'm not like trying to pick on any particular companies in this video, maybe except for Lethal Performance, because their shipping prices are completely retarded. At least the last time I checked, maybe they've come down, but I haven't bought anything from them for a long time because their shipping prices were a little on the insane, nuts, and crazy side. So that's all the parts that I wanted to bring up. There are a few others that I saw. They were like minor increases of like $8, $5, stuff like that, but I wasn't going to nitpick for this video. I just wanted to get like the most substantial ones as far as prices go. So now I'm going to go through each one in order of how I showed it, what the increase was for each particular part that I showed, and the total amount cost of what it would cost to buy these parts now versus what I spent at the time for when I actually bought them. First up are the drilled and slotted rotors. At the time I bought them, they were $124. Now they are $224. Next was the Maximum Motorsport subframe connectors. Before, they were $194. Now they are $229. Next up was the Lethal Performance 26 spline input shaft. Before, it was $299. Now it is $359. Next up was the Koni shocks and struts. Before, they were $766. Now they are $897. Now the exhaust components. Before, the Boiler Stingers were $763. Now they cost $1,095. And the last item on this list are the ARH long tubes. Before, they were $1,706. They are now $2,113. So altogether, out of all the parts that I picked out for this, the total cost to buy all these parts right now versus when I had bought them previously, it is an increase of $1,065, which is a pretty good chunk. I mean, that's money now that could go towards other mods that people, you know, you can't do that now. That money's tied up just in buying parts like that, instead of being able to allocate it towards other things because of the price increases on a lot of parts. And like I said before, this isn't all the parts on the car. There's probably more things that have gone up in price, but I have a lot of parts on the car and it's a lot of time to go through everything. But these are the ones that stood out to me the most overall. So in time, will these prices come back down to where they were, or will manufacturers and companies continue this trend of things are just going to cost more for parts going down the road? Hopefully, in time, they start to come down. I guess time will tell, and it probably won't be in the near future, but hopefully, at some point, things do change for the better as far as modern cars go. But in the comments, let me know what things have you noticed that you have bought for your car that have gone up in price since you bought it, or things that you've been sitting on wanting to buy, and while you've been waiting, they've also been going up in price, which doesn't help at all. Well, that will conclude this video. If you did enjoy the video, leave it a like, it is greatly appreciated. And if you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. It does help the channel out quite a bit, and I would appreciate it very much. Plus, it's free, and you can always unsubscribe in the future, but you won't because there's some good Cobra stuff coming up, especially for 2023. But above all else, thanks for watching.